do something for me, for me, for me. Good afternoon, everyone. My name is Christy Perez, and I'm the program coordinator here at the Brooklyn Young Mothers Collective. On behalf of BYMC and our Great Expectations Leaders Program, I would like to welcome everyone for coming out to our first town hall meeting, Communication, the First Lesson Starts at Home, Creating Healthy Families.
The crux of this conversation is going to be about a shift in the paradigm, right? So we're going to talk about how we do things one way and how we can better do them another way. So one of those things, conversation. How do we improve conversation? Parent to parent, partner to partner, parent to child, experienced parent to new parent who is also child, right? So we're going to have a conversation about how we make these conversations take place in healthy ways that are productive for our families, whether we're in the same house or we're in different houses, but how we can have healthy conversations so that we can have healthy children, healthy in mind, healthy in body, healthy in spirit.
Now in this country, 24 million of our children wake up each morning without their biological father in their homes. 70% of that 24 million are minority children that wake up each and every morning without their biological fathers in their homes. As you know right now, 70% of our minority children, both particularly African American children, are born into out of wedlock households, which almost always lead into being in a single family household. 50% of our marriages in divorce. Am I creating a devastating picture for you?
Yeah.
For our community, and I am not a statistical person. I hate statistics, but I do think that it lays the foundation for this conversation that we're going to have, because I'm a conversation person. I like having conversation around the issue, but I like giving some foundation to where we are headed.
Our boys were growing up without seeing a man shave, without seeing a man resolve conflict, getting up and going to work. And we model that which we see.
I actually grew up in a single parent household. And me being a new father, I'm also trying to look for that. I'm also trying to look for that advice from my father, who's there, but he's not there like he should be. So as far as me having a male mentor to guide me and, you know, guide me down the path of fatherhood in the right manner, that's something right now that's somewhat absent in my life. But despite that, I'm doing the best that I can with the hardships, and I'm just making sure that, you know, everything is completely fine with my family and myself.
A nation can never rise higher than this woman and the women and children. And that was my orientation as a child, that you valued women and children and you made sure that they had everything that they needed, because no nation can get better or stronger if the foundation, the women and children, are weakened.
Having two kids and going to school and working is what I needed. So it was really good for me, and I finished my first semester with a 3.2 GPA. Mm-hmm. And I feel that this makes me a role model for my kids, because I'm letting them know that mommy is going back to school, and, you know, having all these obstacles in front of her, you know, it's nothing you can't do. So I feel that I'm actually stronger than ever, and I feel that I was already strong, but, you know, Benita and everybody else helped me actually, you know, and, you know, push that and showed it. So, yeah, that's why I'm just happy that they was there, and, you know, they stuck by me and didn't, you know, let me fall, because they knew I was better than that and stronger than that. And yeah.
After I had my daughter, I noticed that I had to face a lot of things like other people's images about me. I mean, even one time a paramedic, I passed out. A couple of weeks after my C-section, and a paramedic decided to lecture me throughout my whole journey to the hospital about why 16-year-old girls shouldn't be teenage parents. And I felt that really hurt me, because I was like, you don't know what your 16-year-old daughter is doing while you're busy lecturing me. And he was so sure that his daughter's perfect while he's gonna look down on me. And I was like, that's mostly the regular person's mentality. Mm. So about 7 weeks later, after I had birth, unfortunately, my child passed away. there I had an issue with ACS, and ACS and the detective decided to throw in my face as well that I was a 16-year-old. And they had this image about me. Oh, maybe, was it because you weren't prepared? Is it because you really didn't want to be a mother that you hurt your child, when I knew perfectly well I didn't hurt her?
If you've been in family courts across the country, they are typically a woman-centered environment in that women are responsible for going to court to try to hold their families together, in the sense that young women are the ones that respond to abuse and neglect petitions. In fact, in New York State, up until recently, even if the mother of the children that were the subject of proceedings in family court, they filed them under the mother's name, even if she wasn't involved or even if she was dead. This is how they kept track of the children in court. You put women in a position where they're constantly responding to petitions to try to hold on to their children, you'll never ever be able to break the cycle of poverty. In New York City, the average family court case takes 4 to 5 years to resolve. So you're talking 4 to 5 years, your family has been destabilized because of state intervention.
Today is a new day. I think a lot of times we feel that if we messed up one day, or even if getting pregnant constituted messing up, right? I mean, for most people, they didn't plan to have a baby, so maybe someone said to you, you messed up. But, you know, that whether or not that was the mess up, that you can still create a very positive situation out of, you know, what may have been perceived by yourself or by others to be a negative situation. I mean, a lot of people walking around today, you don't know their story. You know, a lot of people were not planned, and they may have come out of all kinds of situations. You know, people don't wear that on their sleeve.
Said that really struck me when he talked about having a model, and he talked about his relationship with his father, and that he was, you know, maybe looking for that kind of mentoring. And sometimes there's resources that are right in front of you. And so I wanted to certainly offer up Kenny Braswell's phone number and his mentoring for you. And mine as well. And I say that somewhat in tongue in cheek, but we're not perfect fathers. We got a couple years on you, a couple more children. But this, use it. While there's a formal organization like Brooklyn Young Mothers Collective, use us, get our numbers, and use us as mentors as well.
We get a lot of second chances in life, you know, so every day that you have a new day, because as a parent, it's a growing, it's a learning experience, and what you did yesterday, you know, you may not want to do today. I mean, I'm a mother of four, and some days, you know, every day is like, okay, new beginning. There's some things I did yesterday that I don't want to do today. You know, I want to do it differently. I want to do it better. I want to be a better parent, for my children, and so every day is an incredible journey. And just embrace it, celebrate who you are, celebrate the good things that you're doing, and I pray that you continue to have much support around you.
Time to choose my foes, choose my friends, be with my family. They've been asking, girlfriend, where you been? We ain't seen you in weeks. Been chasing this fool around, thinking he gon' hold me down. That I needed
real commitment.
I really couldn't see it.
Not the real man
you said you would be in
this relationship.